We got Watch JR Go in the house. You ride that thing like you know what you're doing.
Dude, the ABS is pretty cool.
JR just happened to come over and he was like, you want to sell it? And I was like, yeah, I'll sell it. All right, now do that wheelie. No. What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to, I almost said Watch JR. Welcome back to Auto Auction Rebuilds. And we got a special guest today. He's out here. It's a little dark. Hold on now. He's out here playing with his bike.
Oh, no!
Yeah, go. Watch JR go. Hopefully, Watch JR go doesn't fall.
Oh, I'm not going to fall.
Bike don't scare you at all, huh?
Oh, no. Well, dude, my Ducati is probably triple.
You have a Ducati?
Yeah, I've got an 1198.
Oh.
Yeah, 1198, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go. This bike terrifies hell out of me. That's this video, I don't know when this video is going to come out. I didn't even know I was making this video, but I ended up buying another bike because this one just, it's, everybody told me, they said that's not the right bike to learn on.
Hey, it's a little twitchy, yeah.
Yeah.
So I had the baby, the one that you wanted for your learning bike. I had the 390, right?
Yeah.
And that thing, like, no matter how hard you beat on it, like, on the highway, with the throttle whacked wide open, it'll only go, like, 88 miles an hour.
Perfect.
Like, I guess I got it to 100 one time in perfect conditions, but, like, the 390 is gutless if you're experienced, but as a beginner, it's pretty amazing.
Right.
But it still sits this high, which is kind of tough for beginners.
Yeah.
Your new bike is like awesome.
Yes. Well, at the minute I saw, I was looking for a Sportster 500, but they don't make them anymore.
Sure. Yeah, the Sportster's gone.
I started looking all around. I couldn't find one for sale. And I was like, so wherever they, I don't know where they went, but they're gone and nobody's selling them.
Right.
So
people
I went,
like them. That's the
apparently
problem.
So. Yeah, yeah. I went to Harley Davidson's website. I was like, what is the new entry level bike? And I saw it was an 883. And I was like, 883?
Mm-hmm.
That's too big.
Right.
And then when I get to the dealership, they're like, you don't want the 883. They're like, trust me, you'll be back in 3 months.
Absolutely.
So they said, get the 1200. And I was like, I feel like I'm at a car dealership, man. It's just keep getting talked, but they were right.
Yeah, yeah, they were right. They're not wrong about that, man. V-twins are so different with the displacement, which is weird because, like, this is just a twin, but it's not a V-twin.
It's a parallel,
like,
right?
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. It, this makes a lot of power. And the Harleys, when you go to the Harley dealership, they're like, dude, this has 100 horsepower. Like, yeah, man, I'm used to riding, like, 200 plus. I don't understand. So yeah, Harleys are they're their own thing. And you know what? It's kind of fun when you're just out idling around cruising because you've got all that low end torque and
that's all I'm gonna do.
Yeah.
I have no intentions of even going on the highway.
Oh yeah.
Like I'm still getting adjusted to just driving on the street going 45.
Yeah.
I haven't ridden a bicycle in I can't tell you how many years.
Uh-huh.
So getting on a motorcycle, just especially this thing, you know, Jessica was freaking out, man. She's like, oh, and everybody on Instagram was like, you're going to kill yourself. You're going to die.
This should be a ripper. It's not the big one, but it's a ripper.
She moves, but again, I don't know anything about bikes. Huh. All I could tell you is it almost threw me off on 15th Street the other day, and that's when I decided I needed something that weighed more than 300 pounds.
I believe it.
Yeah, you want to take it for a spin?
Yeah, man, I'll take this.
It's legal, man. It's legal. Hop on, and you don't even need a key, man.
I love it.
You don't even. I did fix the gas tank the other day. I did it off video. My subscribers are going to be mad at me, but I did fix the gas tank because it was just wide open.
Yes.
And I figured falling over with exhaust and hot engine with an open gas tank may not be a good idea.
Yeah, it'd be a little iffy.
Yeah.
Run.
Yeah.
That's my advice if that happens.
Yeah. Just leave the bike and run.
All right, I'm out.
Yeah, I'll go open this gate up for you, man. All right. Can see how it rides. Be careful now. I think give your Ducati a run for his money.
Probably will. Can I read it?
Yeah, go for it, man. You break it, you buy it. Oh, wow. I could never do that with that bike. I'm too scared. He's ripping it, man. I don't even think he's really being that hard on it either. He's just having some fun. That's crazy. Oh. So, what are you doing there, man?
Look, man, screw me. I came up here for one reason, and it was to drop off the old Porsche 944 I just sold.
Oh, dude, what'd you get rid of that for?
Because I was like, man, I'm going to clear the place out, right? So it was like a great mission, right?
Yeah.
Clearing a car out, getting some money, and then I came to hang out with you, and then apparently I'm taking this home now.
I had no idea. Honest to God, guys, no joke. This wasn't pre-planned or anything. Like,
it wasn't. I just kind of like it. And I was like, I have to buy it if you're getting rid of it.
Well, I mean, I told him it was going to go to auction as soon as I change out a few parts on it anyway. So I gave him a pretty good deal on it. I think it's a good deal.
I think it's what I'm getting. Yeah, all right. It's a good deal.
All right, good. It's a good deal for him. It's a good deal for me because the content really was we bought a bike. We got it running. And we brought it home, and I rode it in the backyard and fell down a few times.
And you rode a 690 for your first bike.
Yeah. So I'm done. Ridiculous. I'm done. I got a new bike now. And look, I got it. Hey, here you go.
That's awesome, dude.
I got a bag. Those boxes that you handed me are probably all parts for this.
Oh, cool.
So there's probably quite a bit of stuff in there for you right now.
Are you going to show them your new bike, or are you keeping that a secret?
No, I'm keeping that a secret.
Okay.
I
think that should be on the DL.
Yeah, they already know what it is.
Yeah, you did.
I should probably show them. I should probably show them. I love this trailer. I bet it pulls like there's nothing behind it.
Yeah, it's super light.
So how's your truck doing? I've hesitated to comment about Fords.
Oh, it's fine. Other than the check engine light being on. I mean, if the check engine light wasn't on, it wouldn't have the warm glow in the interior.
So ambient lighting. Yeah. That's how my BMW is too. Yeah, without the yellow light, it just doesn't feel right in the cab of the car.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's just how I locate my gauges. I see the orange light. There we go.
I promise you there's no gas in it.
Yeah, we'll just throw it up here. Throw it out for the handlebars. She'll be good.
Now, those rod knocks don't bother you, right?
Rod knocks.
That's the first thing I thought when I heard that thing fired up. I was like, is that a rod knocking?
Nope.
I don't know, man.
That's just the old KTM sound, I guess.
Yeah, I took it to the KTM dealer, and they were just, they weren't overly friendly with me.
You bought this?
Yeah.
I assume that they just want to sell the new one. Here's the thing.
Yeah.
The new one has a color display.
Okay.
And like the color display makes me so happy.
Okay. My Harley doesn't have any display.
No, you
there's
just
have nothing, just a speedometer.
You know what's funny though is your Harley has more than that because you can flip through a whole bunch of stuff
that's
on it.
Yeah. But just at a glance, like this has got an LCD screen.
Right.
Yeah, I went there.
Look how far out the chain.
Okay, so that's.
That chain is
that
trash.
I really was like, I think, yeah. I looked at that and I said, you know, I'm not a motorcycle person. But I really do feel like that chain is out of whack a little bit.
Yeah, it needs there's a lot of adjustment left though.
Okay.
It might be okay.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know anything about that. Hey, it's your problem now, man.
Yeah, I'll do some cleaning.
Yeah, it's all yours. All right. So, he's already got the bike loaded up and then he came back and he looked at this and he's like, "Well, what do you want for this one?" And I said, you know, 15.5.
15.5. That sounds like a pretty reasonable deal.
Okay. Well, you know, take it for a ride and if you like it, man, it's yours. It's all yours. This is the new bike, guys. For those of you that haven't followed me on Facebook and Instagram, you really should. I mean, it's free. I'm not charging you or anything. But you get sneak peeks of this. Like, you see this like 4 days before you're ever going to see it on the channel.
It's got four on it.
4 miles.
I already can't afford this. I'm telling you right
4
now.
Miles. This is the new bike, man. This is the bike reveal. This is the 2021 Harley Davidson Sportster. And I was going to go with the Iron 883. And the people at Harley Davidson talked me out of. They said, you don't want the 883. Trust me, you'll be back in 3 months trying to replace it with the 1200. So just, and if you don't know this, they have the freedom guarantee at Harley Davidson. So every dollar I pay on this bike, they give it back to me when I trade it in.
Oh,
I won't lose a dime on this bike. So every dollar that I pay on this bike, when it comes time for me to trade up, so like a bigger street bike, if I trade it back into them anyway, to that dealership, they'll give me 100% of my money back on it.
That's impressive.
Yeah, so I was like, sold. Sold. Didn't cost me anything extra. It's based on credit.
Yeah.
And when they told me my credit was like a 740, I was like, what, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is what I've seen.
I was like, did you pull the right credit file? Because I checked it a couple days ago. Could have swore it was like still at a 640. He said, no, you're a 740, so you qualify for the freedom guarantee, the extended warranty. Like, it's all
nice.
And I was like, cool beans, man.
It's even got a gear indicator, which is awesome.
Yeah.
Can't beat that. It's kind of, you know, that used to be such a. And only high-end bikes had gear indicators. And now this thing has that and the tach. And
yeah, tach and gear indicator there. And you scroll through all your little options right there. I've driven it 0.4 miles. Your clock. I leave it on gear and RPM.
Oh, yeah.
Just because I'm still brand new to it. And yeah. I feel really good knowing what gear I'm in.
You'll probably always want it on there anyway.
Okay.
Yeah.
They even filled the tank up for me.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, I was like, wow, you put gas in it too? They don't even do that for me when I buy cars.
No.
Maybe they should, but there you go, guys. Look, for those that are going to say it's not my bike or whatever, God, the people that troll, our Shear. Oh, you can't see that. Okay, there you go. That is my name. No, it's not the biggest, nicest $36,000 Harley that they have, but it's a good starter bike.
Those bikes are definitely not starter bikes anyway.
No.
Like, if anything happens to them, you're just upside down immediately.
I got a buddy that owns a couple, and he said that one of his bikes weighs 1,100 pounds.
Oh, yeah.
And I asked him, what happens if you drop it?
You get another person.
He said, you don't drop it.
You don't drop it.
He said, you don't drop it. He said, yeah, you just don't drop your bike.
If my Goldwing went down, it'd be a thing. I mean, you gotta do the whole get behind it, squat.
That's what he was telling me.
It's a huge deal. Or, luckily, anytime someone's fallen on a touring bike with us, there's enough of us around, and like, as long as everyone's paying attention, like, you kick your kickstand down and like run to help them and try to save the bike.
So, you've been riding bikes how long?
Since I was five. That's when I got my first bike.
Yeah, you've been riding a while then.
Yeah, never stopped. Yeah, it is something I love.
So what do you have to say to the people that say it's dangerous? I can't tell you. My comments have been flooded with people that say you're stupid. It's dangerous. Bikes are deadly. You're going to die. You should never ride a motorcycle.
Well, my take on that is we're all going to die.
I just said that in this video earlier.
That's literally it. Like, enjoy your life. You can't just sit inside and be scared.
Thank you.
I mean, I love cars too, and there are times when you're like, the only time I worry on a bike now is if what happened to me on the Goldwing again in the middle of Colorado happened, where I lose a tire and I'm 7 hours in each direction from civilization. Like,
oh Lord,
that's terrible. Because I mean, it's hard to push a Goldwing 700 miles home, you know.
Hey, you just leave it on the side of the road. What do? Call a tow truck.
No, you stay with the bike, and you either pay for a tow that costs more than a car would normally cost, or you call a friend. So, you know, ride with groups, that helps.
Yeah.
That's really
good. Yeah. I do have my limitations. My fiance, and I said this in a Copart video that I recorded earlier today. I was talking about all the people. I said exactly what you did. Yep. I'm terrified of motorcycles because some things happened to me when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. My dad had a little Honda that he bought from my uncle. Mm-hmm. Coincidentally, my uncle commented on this bike and told me basically I'm an idiot for buying a motorcycle. And it's like, wait a minute. You used to ride one because you sold it to my dad.
Yes.
It caught on fire with me on the back of it, started burning my leg.
Yeah.
And then my mom tried to ride it for the first time and hit a parked car right in a, like, literally right in our neighborhood. She came back covered in blood. I mean, and I'm just like this 4 or 5 year old kid.
Right.
So my experience with motorcycles from the beginning,
dramatic.
I said I will never touch a bike. And look, I got one now. There's the other ones out there now.
Yeah, stack them.
I had two of them within a week because as soon as I got on it, I was like, no, I got to do this.
A funny story was when I was a kid, I hit a parked car because we had a van that dad was like flipping or something like that, right? And it was sitting, we had a hill with stairs going up behind the house, right? And I had like a Yamaha Enduro 175. So
yeah, so 175cc bike.
Yeah. It's a big dirt bike. It's actually funny. My dad wouldn't help me when I dropped that bike. That, you know, that was the rule. If you're going to ride the bike, you got to be able to pick it up.
Yeah.
Which is a good general rule. So, you know, there were times when I'd like drop it because I jumped something and then I'd just be like stuck out in the field and I'm like, well, I guess if I'm getting at home, I'd walk back and be like, I need help. He's like, no, go get that thing, man. And I'd do it. You know, I'd go out there and pick the bike back up and ride it back. So
yeah.
It's a good way to learn for sure. And then I kept jumping the hill, and this one time I didn't see that this minivan, an old Dodge Caravan, had like been parked at the top of the hill suddenly. So I jumped the hill.
Oh no.
And then it just like slammed right into the thing, and I went flying. But it was okay. It didn't really hurt the van too bad, and I was fine. I was a kid.
You lived through it.
Yeah, when you were a kid.
Look at that. Yeah. Look at that. You lived through. I can't tell you how many people have commented, oh, I know this guy that died, and I'm sure it happens all the time. I'm at Copart, and I see the wrecks. It does happen, but, you know, I'm 41, and I got a lot of people saying this is a midlife crisis. It's like, I bought a Corvette when I was 26, and that was not a midlife crisis.
Right.
I've had many Corvettes since, and now I want to try out bikes because it's not a midlife crisis.
Yeah.
It's facing a fear, a lifelong fear. I want to face that demon and get over it.
Yeah.
And I'm getting there. Now, there's another thing I'm afraid of that I will never try, and that's jumping out of airplanes.
Ah.
My fiance, when I proposed to her, said there was a condition upon us getting married, and that was I have to jump out of an airplane with her.
Ah.
And I love the woman so much, I told her yes.
Uh-huh.
Thankfully, she came to her senses.
And didn't want to do it anymore?
And she didn't want to do it. And I can't say with all honesty that I would have done it. I meant it when I said it.
Yeah.
But chances are very good that if we had even gotten me into the airplane, there's no way in hell I'd have jumped out of it.
The thing is, once you're on that airplane, you're jumping out. They're like, are you ready? And you're like, no. And then they're like, okay, we're going to go on three. Tell me if you want to stop. And they're like, one. And they just jump. And you don't have a choice.
I wish you wouldn't have told me that.
Yeah. If you get in a skydiving airplane, you're getting out with a parachute. You're not going
to. Okay.
You're not ever landing.
Well, that's good to know. So. Sweetheart, if you watch this video, I'm not stepping foot on one of those airplanes now.
Or those guys are professionals. I mean, it's one of those. I mean, it's. Accidents in skydiving seem like really, really rare.
Yeah.
And actually far more rare than motorcycle accidents.
That doesn't surprise me, you know, yeah. But I'm the type, I feel out of control.
Well, yeah, you're definitely not.
Which is why I could have flown to California.
Uh-huh.
And granted, there wouldn't have been much content in that, but I could have flown to California, been there in a few hours.
Sure.
Versus driving this and
this
taking
is an experience.
26 hours. Even, like, I don't even care. Electric car, gas car, I'm driving over flying every time. Because I like to know my hand's on the wheel, my foot's on the pedal. At least I have some control over what's going on.
All of my math is strictly based on statistics. Planes don't crash very often. Skydivers don't have that many accidents.
Yeah.
Roller coasters never fail. And what's weird is I still love motorcycles, but that's like the worst one there is. Like, everybody gets hurt on these, but it's no big deal. It's just be careful.
Yeah.
It runs like a new bike. There's no shape with the handlebars. This does have ABS.
They said it doesn't.
Oh, it doesn't.
Oh, I was going to say, if it does, that was like a $700 option for free.
It has the light.
Okay, yeah, yeah. They said if you don't order it from factory with ABS, they don't come with it. Yeah, no, it's not available.
I'm not going to go out on the road.
That bike is so easy to ride, guys. Like, I'm not even joking with you. That bike is so much easier to ride than the KTM. I had no intention of selling the KTM just yet. We were going to take that to the auction as soon as we got done with it. But I figured the majority of the content is done. You know, we took a bike that we didn't know if it ran or not, and we got it running. And I rode it for the first time, and I got the bug. I caught the bug, man. I got the itch. And JR just happened to come over, and he was like, you want to sell it? And I was like, yeah, I'll sell it. All right, now do that wheelie. No.
This thing is nimble.
Right?
Yeah.
That's one of the things I really loved about it, man.
Yeah. It's legit, like, easy to ride.
Yes.
You already ordered the exhaust? I just assume you already ordered the exhaust.
No, not yet. I'll have to, though. The guy told me, he said, you know, buying a Harley is your down payment on the accessories.
That's right. That's right.
And I said, surely they can't be that expensive.
Oh, God.
They are.
That exhaust is like $2,500.
Yeah. You know what I'll do? I'll find one used on eBay.
Yeah.
That's, I don't mind used parts.
Man, this is crazy. Oh, okay. There's a crossover tube right here. And I'm sure the aftermarket one's given.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you see
that? Yeah, I hadn't even seen that. Yeah.
Pretty interesting.
Dude, did you scratch it?
Got its own.
No, I'm kidding.
No.
God, they really want to know how I'm liking the bike, I guess. Yeah, guys, I'll put this on the handlebars. We'll go for a ride here in a little bit. I'm gonna let him get on his way.
Yeah.
Big shout out to JR, man, from Watch JR Go. If you don't know who he is, I'm sure you do. He's got more subscribers than me. Jump over to his channel. I'll have a link down in the description. Go check him out.
Thanks, man. Thanks for selling me a bike that I...
Hey, thanks for buying it, man.
I didn't take anything else home. I was so excited to be empty trailer. Here I am.
Yeah, he shows up with an empty trailer, not for long. I didn't know I was selling it. Like, I was figured he was going to make a video on the bike today, yeah. Actually. So when you said you want to sell it, I was like... Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll sell it. Yeah, and I don't have to work on it, man.
That's right.
Yeah, so speaking of, since he's going to be working on that bike, you're definitely going to want to go check it out on his channel for all the people that were...
Real quick.
Yeah, yeah, go check him out because he found a couple other things that need to be done to it. The chain's a little loose and that one shock on the front.
General maintenance stuff.
Yeah,
yeah, but this shock's leaking. It needs
needs
seals, fork seal action. But it'll be fun.
Yeah, and I'm going to give him all this. I've got mirrors and spark plug and air filter, and I gave him the oil and stuff. So everything that comes in for him, I'm going to give it to him. The ignition is, he's already got that. So he can do the videos on it. He'll have that done. And
absolutely.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah.
So go check out Watch JR Go. Let's jump on this bike and go for a ride. All right, guys, how about a quick ride? See how this thing does. Not, but look, remember, I just started riding, guys. Like, I've been riding for all of about 3 days now. So, just try not to laugh too much. I guess that's going to about wrap it up for the video, guys. Big shout out to Watch JR Go coming out here and hanging out. Definitely cool seeing him. We don't get to meet up very often, but I think I'm going to have to take a trip up to Kansas and go visit him sometime in the near future. So hopefully the bike does well for him, man. You know, since I don't know anything about bikes, that bike kind of sketched me out because I don't know the history behind it. I don't know what's been done, how hard it's been ridden, or what needs to be done to it, whereas he is a bike expert. So I know a lot of people are going to be like, I can't believe you got rid of it, and I can't believe you bought a brand new Harley Davidson. Well, I need you to try to understand it from my point of view. I had no clue what was going on with that bike, no clue what it actually needed, whereas he knows, he bought it knowing good and well what he's getting into, and that makes me feel good. I gave him a good deal on it, so we're both happy. From my perspective, a guy trying to learn how to ride a bike, that bike, granted, I learned how to ride it. I did. I have never ridden a motorcycle before in my life, and I learned on that bike. I'm able to get up and down the road now because of that bike. The bike served its purpose. It got me the itch. But at the end of the day, it's the same reason I don't personally drive salvage yard cars as daily drivers. I'm the type of guy that likes to know that all of my stuff is new. Now, that doesn't mean it's not going to break. But generally, it just makes you feel better. It gives me peace of mind knowing, especially on two wheels, that the brakes are all brand new. The engine is brand new. Everything is brand spanking new. I don't have to worry about neglected maintenance. I've got a brand new bike that I can feel fairly confident, comfortable, and safe on. Now, there's a difference between feeling comfortable, safe, and confident, and arrogant. That's not me. As you guys saw, I am not there yet, guys. I'm not. I am still learning. I'm very new. Like, I've been riding bikes for a whopping 3 or 4 days now. So definitely got a long, long way to go. But I bought the Harley because it was cheap, guys. That bike was like $99.95, or no. $10.5, something like that. It was a relatively cheap bike. It's a great entry-level bike, beginner bike. I got the warranty and everything, so I don't really have to worry too much about the bike itself. I can focus more on riding and less on worrying about where the brake pads replaced. Are my shocks going bad? I don't need to stress over that stuff, guys. So hopefully you understand that. A lot of you have been asking if I'm going to take the motorcycle safety class. Yes, 100%. In fact, as soon as I get done editing this video, I'm going to call them and set up my appointment to get started with the motorcycle training course. I'm going to go that route for sure, 100%. Many of you have recommended it, and I have listened. and I'm going to do it. And hopefully we'll have some moto vlogs coming in the future as just a new part to the channel. And hopefully I can help inspire and maybe encourage some of you out there that have been on the fence about getting a motorcycle to just get up and do it. You know, quit thinking about it, just get up and do it. Yeah, it's scary. Of course it's scary. And hell, it's kind of terrifying, especially on a KTM 690 Duke. Don't buy that bike as your first as your first bike if you've never ridden a bike before. You know, get yourself something a little smaller, man. And I don't care what it is. I'm not going to sit here and preach to you Harley, Indian, Vulcan, Honda. It doesn't matter, guys. BMW. It doesn't matter. I'm not that guy. I'm not that guy that's going to sit here and rag on you because you bought a different product than what I bought. You know, it's personal preference. If you prefer an Indian, go get you an Indian, man. If you prefer a Kawasaki, go get you a Kawasaki. Me personally, I just kind of fell in love with the Harley. I don't know what it is exactly yet. It's just, it touched my heart in a way that I just had to have it. So now I do. Guys, I'm going to get out of here. If you enjoyed the content, definitely hit the thumbs up button. Please hit the thumbs up button. Share the video with your friends. Don't forget to go follow John Ross. Watch JR go. Down below, click the link, go subscribe to his channel to see where he's going with the KTM 690 Duke. I'll be watching that definitely for myself. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram, Auto Auction Rebuilds. And until next time, stay safe out there, buddy. I look forward to seeing you all very soon in the next one.